project we have started at Pyramid Valley, Bangalore, by the name of Consciousness Engineering Research Foundation, for which Dr. Nathan is also one of our patrons, in addition to Pramod Patiji. And that is where we are promoting the work of increasing the understanding of spirituality and spiritual matters from a scientific perspective. It's a research-based organization. And as a part of our activity, we have the privilege of working with Kaya and Christiane Moller from Canada, who run their foundation known as University Ekayan UCN. And they are here in India for a 1.5 month lecture tour. And they have taken time out from their tour to make this very special visit to the Mecca of spirituality, the new age spirituality, that is Life Research Academy. Unfortunately, Dr. Newton couldn't be here today due to his other preoccupations. So, I'll just give a brief introduction. Kaya, who's here, and his wife, Christiane Moller, they are the world's most renowned authority on teaching people the language of dreams, signs, and symbols. As Kaya says, the universe speaks to us in the language of signs, symbols. And the most important platform on which this communication happens is your dreams. And they say that if you really want to unravel the mystery of the universe, it is almost essential and mandatory that we all understand and learn the language of dream science and symbols. That is what will lead us to our spiritual autonomy. And then they work with a very interesting concept of 72 angels, which Kaya will tell you more about. And their approach to this entire field is purely in the language of science, which is understood by the present generation of India and the new children, the youth, the old, all alike. Because it's a universal language, it has always been there, it will always be there. And friends, I would request you to please give a big round of applause. And thank you very much for your presence. And let's hear, in the words of Kaya and Christiane, the mystery of this universal language that we all need to know. Thank you.
There's a new beginning now that is helping us to enter in a new step in the evolution of humanity. India has always been a jewel of spirituality for a long, long, long time. And is about to become one of the first economy in the world in the years to come. The challenge with the changes that we are going through are very, very important. It is important to bring spiritual knowledge to the new generations. Unless they will disconnect themselves from their tradition. Because the meditation of Grand God is sometimes something that they don't understand. They are in video games. They are playing. They have already have their iPhones. So, why should they sit and meditate while it takes so long to understand? Spirituality can be very abstract. And symbolic language is the key for these new generations to achieve an understanding of what meditation is. Symbolic language explains to us when we meditate, we can receive symbols, we can understand, that we can receive answers. For certain peoples, meditation is more a spiritual communication than an understanding. We use sometimes meditation to escape, to flee from our realities and from our difficulties. With symbolic language, we can give a new meaning to meditation. We can understand that life is like a dream. And the metaphysical and the physical world are profoundly connected. An angel is not just a little being with wings, a cute baby that we see sometimes. It is a metaphor. It has always been a metaphor for a long, long, long time, explaining the notion that the wings, in fact, were the representation of our capacity to dream. It is a human with wings. So it's very, very ancient knowledge that is part of every tradition of the world. We have the notion of angels in the Indian tradition, the Muslim, the Christian. All traditions of the world have been talking about angels, but not really knowing what they were exactly. Because they were a notion of representing our spiritual powers and the immense capacity that we all have within ourselves. My path started about 20 years ago, and I started to receive very intense dreams and nightmares. It was so intense. I was confused. And I was trying to understand what was happening within myself. But at the same time, I was just fascinated by symbols. I just wanted to know more and more and more. And because I knew it was God that was talking. But it was difficult sometimes because, you know, you have nightmares and you see things that sometimes that are so negative. So you say, what's going on? What is the meaning of that? I'm a good person. I'm a spiritual person. I try to do my best. I haven't done anything wrong in my life. And I start to receive nightmares. So one day we understand that nightmares are just the little fractions of who we are. That our soul is a living computer. And we record positive and negative memories through all our experiences, patience, and all our lives. And that memory that we accumulate over time create who we are and create what we have as potentials or the difficulties that we can encounter in our life or inside us. This is why we are all different. But past lives is something that is very, very important to understand who we are. And I know that Dr. Newton and his wife here are doing such an amazing work to understand the process of the impact of memories on our evolution and on who we are. If we can change these memories, we can cleanse them to transform ourselves. So, an angel is a state of consciousness. It is not a person. It is an energy, a forces that represents pure powers of God. It is very, very ancient. It's thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago. At the same time, where all the traditions were meeting, Hindu, they had different gods. They were all those gods also. Represents the sky, the capacity. Travel, to have powers. And there's so much amazing symbolism in the Indian mythology. It's amazing. When we know symbolic language, we can go so deep in the understanding. Why one of the gods had many hands and the other one were having this animal, this other animal. There was a reason for that. They are not just decoration. They are representations of forces. And symbolic language can help us to understand. With symbolic language, we cannot only understand our dreams. We can understand also our day-to-day realities. We can make a link with metaphysical and physical dimensions. So, in a dream, you see a defragmentation of your consciousness through the multi-dimensions and the symbols that you see. Let's say you have a dream that is in connection with your work. Then you can see yourself being in your workplace. Then you have like an animal that is there in your workplace. What is he doing there? Or there's your nephew that is there. And then he's there. And then there's another symbol. All of these symbols will express forces, positive or negative aspects that you have within yourself when you work. It will be like a mirror. An understanding of who you are deeply. A dream is not just a cycle of images. A dream is in fact a life program. And this is now being in this new technology that we have now, computers, all these extraordinary tools that we have can make us understand even more the potential that we have within ourselves. We have this inner computer inside of us that can record all the time information, and this information creates who we are. So in the time, you know, thousands, thousands of years ago, Hindu tradition, they had many gods. The Greeks, they had many gods. The Romans had many gods. The Greeks had many gods. The Babylonians, they were representing different forces of the universe. And it was at the same period of time that the angels have been received by sage and have been put in place in sort to create a notion of understanding different states of consciousness. It was an oral teaching for thousands and thousands of years. And it was was kept secret for a long, long, long time. Because it needed to arrive to our period of time. It needed to enter in the spirit of time where technologies, where spirit and matter will join for the first time. Concrete. So, the text have been rediscovered in 1975 in Gerona, in Spain, after being hidden during the Inquisitions for 500 years. So we know Michael, Gabriel, Raphael, we all know these names, but at the origin of angels and archangels, there were 72 angels and 10 archangels. And all these angels are the representations of different forces of the universe. So for example, we have this angel here, which is Omaya, which is the angel that we are now presenting in this tour here in India for the first time. We are traveling in different cities to introduce people to the work that we can do with angels, to discover our spiritual autonomy. When we meditate with the angel, the work with angels is very, very simple. We use the name of an angel as a mantra, and it triggers dreams. If we don't dream him, after 2-3 weeks of doing the mantra, the dream will start. If we dream already, the dreams will start to be organized. The beautiful dreams will be in the qualities, and our nightmares will be in the human distortions. Because of course an angel is pure, there's an avenue of distortions, but it is us. We try to experiment qualities in our evolution, and we distort the divine energy, and we to experiment. When we develop weaknesses or negativity, then we have to work on ourselves to recreate and refine the original source of quality, divine quality. It is a very, very, very profound work. It's very intense. It creates major, major transformation. Because we can have access to our angelic consciousness. So we start to receive lots of dreams and signs. It starts to create the connection between metaphysical and physical aspects. So we start to meditate and we receive dreams and signs about the angels that we are working with. We attract situation. We start to see the number, for example, 30 everywhere. Everywhere we go, license plate. We have our intention, because when we do a mantra is very, very powerful. It creates a focus. It creates a concentration inside our consciousness. And this concentration creates our capacity to dream and to do out-of-body experience. Angel is the notion of doing out-of-body experience, creating the capacity to travel in the universe, travel in the multi-dimension of the consciousness. I've been working with the angels for over 20 years now, and I still receive almost 10 to 50 to 100 dreams every night because of this work. It's amazing how we can develop our spiritual autonomy. We can receive answers within ourselves, just by doing the mantra, because we enter an array of consciousness of the universe, and we have access to dimensions, to the memories that we have accumulated. Also, we visit our past lives, visit all the essence that have constituted who we are through time, and then we cleanse them, because the angel will help us. Because it's good when you awake. Let's say you awake something, you know, a memory, you know, that was linked with a past life, or linked with your father or mother, whatever. Then what do I do with that? You know, I don't feel good. You know, what do I do? And you need to understand. Okay, this is like a memory, because life is like a dream. So the law of resonance, the law of attraction, explains that I attract who I am, positive and negative. So if I have attracted a mother that was not loving, that's because there was something that I needed to learn. I had karma from past life. So I needed to have this mother to help me to to improve myself and to develop the qualities. It's always the notions. The other person is always a part of us. It's amazing when we understand. And when we start to work with angels, we re-enter. We have access again to Saturn, to the world of truth. But it's very difficult to have access to the world of truth. This is not easy. This is not an easy teaching that we are sharing. It's an initiatic path. Because if you start to do the mantra, you will receive beautiful dreams, extraordinary experience, but you will receive also nightmares. Intense nightmares that will be there to cleanse. Like a volcano, you will open the consciousness. All the memories you have created, and they will be able to re-emerge. And then you are going to be able to transform them by doing the mantra. We have the memories that we have awakened. Then we, oh my, oh my, oh my, oh my. We can chant it. We can do something silently, especially if you're in a cab. It's preferable to do it silently. So then we invoke the angel, and then we can cleanse and we can integrate this consciousness. The more we do the mantra, the more we integrate our spiritual powers that are connected to the angel that we are working with. So Omaya is an angel that is related to multiplication, materialization, development, expansion, production, achievement, application, planning, patience, sense of responsibility. It's related to, relates to the medical profession, fertility, concerns pregnant women, etc. Pattern of the vegetable and the animal kingdom, etc., etc. The human distortion will be sterility, lack of success, repeated failure, corrupt materialization, etc. Quality, impatience, etc. So an angel is a state of consciousness that represents forces of the universe, powers of God, manifestation. An angel is not just an energy, it is also, it can take any form. It's not just the being with wings. This is just like an image to express what can happen within ourselves. An angel is always related to the name of God. So, Omaya means God of multiplication. All the angels are the name of God. So they are the people of the name. This is why when we start to work intensively, it creates a huge opening of our potential and of the unconscious. So there's many angels, you know, this one is the 39 AIL, which is related to submission, receptivity, perfect submission to fair parents, obedience and respect, healing of anxiety, depression and mental illness, regeneration, etc. And then the human distortions, insubordination, rebellion, absence of respect for hierarchy, etc., etc. So there's always like the positive aspect and the human distortion that are there to help us, that we as human, normally we experiment. And because we don't know negativity, sometimes we think it is positive. So it is very important, the more we work with angels, the more we understand that evil is education. It is not something that we need to combat. It is something that we need to transform, to educate. Because in science we know that we can put it down in there. So in science we know that in physics we know that nothing loses itself, it always transforms. See? So it is the same thing with qualities and distortions. It's connected. So if we want to become more patient, what is the way? The only way is to work on our impatience. This is where our positive energy is locked. Because we have experimented all the time, so we have distorted patience without knowing. Sometimes people, they think that just positive thinking will bring them to happiness. Now, a lot of people are using these new age, to really, positive. Yes, of course we need to be positive. Of course. But we need to be positive when we see negativity also. We need to be positive by seeing the negativity. negative situation and say to ourselves, I can transform that. I can help it. What do I have to learn from that? Instead of fighting, being angry. Because one day we realize that life is like a dream. So what does it mean? It means that everyone that I meet is a part of me. If I am bothered by my boss because he's too bossy, you know, he's shaking his key to make sure he knows that he's got a BMW, you know? So then you are disturbed by that. That's because exactly like in a dream, you have memories that are connected with that. Of course you cannot behave like that, but you have maybe 5% of energy of being bossy. And he's got 62%. So of course it is a percentage that creates a manifestation. But for you, it's on an emotional or intellectual level. So when you are bothered, it creates a resonance. It creates a distortion in you. And you don't feel good. But one day, it cleanses. And with time, we are no longer bothered. No longer. It's amazing. And the angel can help us to do that. Can help us to activate the unconscious. To cleanse it. And to work also to create a focus and concentration. Because very often when we do meditation, we can be dispersed. We can go like a little bit everywhere. And we try sometimes to find an emptiness. But the emptiness is the last stage. It is there when you have solved everything. Then you don't have anything to think anymore. Then you feel good. Or it comes naturally. Like a beautiful day when you're outside. And you just feel like being complete. You see, we don't force that. It has to come naturally. So if in our meditation we have a worry that comes, we should meditate on that. We should try to transform that distortion to make it again positive. And okay, why am I insecure about that? What's the reason for that? You know, and then I go back to the divine law. There's no coincidence, I have something to learn, maybe I've done something in a past life, etc., etc. I'm having exactly what I would like to have, but I need to accept my life plan right now. Am I doing the best on every angle of my life? Is there an angle that I can improve? We should use meditation to meditate, to visit our consciousness and our unconscious. We should use meditation also when we want to develop our third eye. We should use like the possibility to meditate on a dream, on something that happened every day or the day before. Then we visualize what we the dream again, like a movie we play it in our head. And by trying to understand this dream, what's the meaning of this dream? You slow it down and then you take one symbol at a time. Okay, this. Of course it's a language. It's a language. And now we are here in India to present. We have done a beautiful foundation, we've done a beautiful alliance, the Pyramid Valley, and Dr. Newton, and Patrici, and the Daga family also, that have put together this new foundation, the Consciousness and Dream Research Foundation, with Anil, who is helping and taking care of many beautiful friends like Arita and Santosh, some of them that you know that are doctors in the team. Students, and so this is like, we have done this alliance to bring this knowledge here in India for the first time. This is known in a lot of countries. We have hundreds and hundreds of thousands of students in more than 43 countries around the world. Even children are working with angels. It's amazing how they can receive their own dreams. They can develop their own spiritual autonomy. And this is what spiritual autonomy with the work of the angel is linked directly to that. We can become a spiritual scientist because we learn to marry spirit and matter. And symbolic language is the key link that needs to connect the understanding. Because sometimes we're in matter and in situation and we are spiritual, And we feel so good when we go for a workshop, for a meditation, or when we come here in this beautiful place where so many great people, we have the possibilities to all everywhere to meet a lot of students from that movement and this life. It's amazing how this what they share is creating beauty. It unifies a lot of beautiful souls. Because when we work deep like you do, working on the memories and past lives, and you enter in the memories of your soul, and you see things and you visualize them, and you try to decode that. And symbolic language can help to continue also this beautiful work. And this is why we are here to release a dictionary. It's called the Source Code, and it's 15 years of work. These last 3-4 years, I've been having 100 of my students, some of them are doctors, professors from many countries, that have been helping on the research to complete this very, very profound work that explained the plus and the minus of each symbol. Because a symbol can always be positive or negative. This is very important to understand that in a dream, an animal, or the wind, or a river, or whatever, can always be not plus or minus. Of course, it's a language, it's a profound language, but it takes time but it's the language of the universe. And it's so important to understand it. And even all the dreams that you are receiving, there's no coincidence what you see. It expresses who we are, it expresses who you are at the present time. It's a visit to the memories, it's a link to your past. It's a link to the present time or to the future also. Through the probabilities of what we can become. To premonitor dreams one day, we can even see the future. We can see collective aspects, thoughts that are about to manifest egregores and forces that will create situations for the evolution of mankind. So this world is like a school, and we live in a living computer. God is a living. And we live inside this immense force of wisdom and pure love and pure synchronicity. Now we have proofs with science, with quantum physics, and explain that it seems to be disorganized, but it's perfectly organized. Nothing can happen, there is no coincidence. And one day, the more we understand symbolic language, the more we understand our dreams, we can see all these forces and these capacities that are preparing life. Because a dream, if we don't understand a dream, eventually the dream will manifest itself. Because it's a life force. Especially if you have a recurring dream, it's a warning, you need to change something. If you don't understand that dream, then eventually something will have to become real. So this way you have the mirror of your own memories. And how our life has been manifested is through like percentage, like statistics. When you have too much anger, too much percentage of anger, then eventually a situation will emerge from you. You will have a situation that you will attract. Like in a dream, you see a symbol that comes in the dream. You will have a person that will represent this in you, and that you will have to face and understand, etc. So this is why one day, it's so amazing to understand that everything that exists, outside exists inside of us in terms of consciousness. And this is why in dreams you can see country, you can see a car, you can see an animal, you can see a forest, a flower. But all this, there's a profound meaning to that. So there's many angels, and all the numbers, of course, are not there by coincidence. They're part of the ancient numerology. Very, very ancient. Here we have 51, Ahasyach, which is related to universal medicine. It's related to infinite goodness, unconditional service. It leads to lasting healing, true understanding, great healer, bearer of universal remedies, etc. Patron of high science. So it's a state of consciousness that creates the knowledge of healing here with millions of different manifestations. So an angel is a force that will take form, that will create a situation in us and all around us. You see the walls, for example, of a house or an apartment it is in connection with a structure. So there's an angel, number 3, Sitara, which is related to structure, construction. So the positive aspect here, if you have a dream, let's say you have a dream, it's a very simple dream. You're here at Life Academy, Life University, you just arrive and you see the wall, and you know that you're here. So what's the purpose of a dream like that? If the wall is very beautiful, it's because you are structuring your learning in connection with the school that you are studying. So you're creating forces and stabilization of your program. This is why it seems very simple to see a dream like that, but there's a profound meaning. Because through seeing a wall of the school, the days after, you will read more, you will study more, you will practice more, you will have a taste of you of structuring and understanding even more, solidifying what you know more. Just a dream like that will trigger a life program, will trigger who you are. This is why it is so profound to understand our dreams, because they are not just cycles of images. This is very, very profound. And the new dictionary, the source code, is an amazing, amazing tool. And it's really something that can help, and that is like becoming like a reference in many, many countries all around the world, because it helps us to accelerate our understanding of what symbol is all about. So then we have another one, which is this one is Kavakya, which is related to family. So if we have family problems, for example, we can use this angel, Kavakya, Kavakya, and we ask the question, well, why do I have attracted a family like that? And then you can receive dreams and you can enter in your past lives to understand why, what you have done in past life that has created this in your life. So you can make a connection. Now, sometimes you can see a family of squirrels, you know, that they're just fighting each other, and you're going to know that there's insecurities related to matter, related to the fear of missing something, you know, having, you know, lack of resources, etc. And then there's the nervous energy of the squirrels. So this is why you see families. So you see that in your family energies and memories, you have major insecurities related to matter, and in your vital energy related to your first chakra, because the animals are related to our needs. So there's a of course, just in 2 hours, we will not have the time to really, but I will try to give you certain keys to understand what this profound work in doing all that. So Verliak is an angel that is related to prosperity, wealth, abundance, joy, etc. So if we have like a difficulty with prosperity, etc., then we can work with this angel to cleanse the memories. Because it's a program. There's a reason why things are not working. You have a company, and you have your other friend, and then everything is fine, you know, you're signing contract, you know, one after the other, and you are meditating and praying and doing everything, and then nothing is happening. Why is that? You have blockages in your memories. There's a reason for that. And there's qualities that you need to improve sometimes. It doesn't mean that your friend is more evolved. Maybe you have experimented in past life, lots of habits. Now you have a limitation because you have not used them very well. And your friend is making karma. He's creating karma because he's at the stage. It's the first time that he's got, it's like, you know, he's like a child and he's like, you know, doing things and he goes fast. And for you, it's like, still, you know what to do, you know, you have, but then it doesn't work. So there's a reason. The memories we can deprogram, we can cleanse these forces. Because one day, there's nothing wrong with prosperity. It's nothing wrong. We can have prosperity on all levels. But for initiates, before we have it on the material world, we prefer to be right unless we know that we are just going to go back and we're just going to go back the stairs, you know, back to stage one in our evolution. And we don't want that. We want to be right. So this is why when we start to manifest ourselves, then we ask questions. This is what I have a lot of compassion sometimes for spiritual people, that they don't know space and bubble language, because they don't have answers. Lots of spiritual people, they don't have true answers. They have feelings or aspects like that, but they don't have true answers of who they are within the family. when they talk to God, it's always a little vague. But when we understand that God and the universe is always talking to us in the secret, and we know this language, deep inside we know it, even if we're not spiritual, we decorate our apartments with symbolic. We can have the color of your car. There's no coincidence. Why have you chosen white and another person has got red car? There's a reason. The person that's going to choose, you know, it's very rare that you see an 80 years, you know, elder to buy a red car. He's going to go for another color. And he's not going to buy a Mustang also. Symbolically, a Mustang doesn't fit with an elder of 80 years old. Of course, sometimes there's some of them, but it's very, very rare. You see, it's not like a common factor that we can put, you know, as a multiplication factor. So there's a common sense with symbolic language. A microphone. What is the symbol in a dream? I had a dream of a microphone. It's a symbol of communication, collective communication. It is the essence, the common sense. Symbolic language is very, very, very logical. Very logical. What is difficult if you see a microphone, and then there was a horse, and then there was mosquitoes all around, and then suddenly you saw a tsunami. It's like, oh my goodness, how do I make this? This is so important. But it's an equation. Mathematics of consciousness. Symbols are mathematics of consciousness. Very logical. It means that when you have collective dimension in your way of sharing with others, you have like sometimes great force of the horse, then positive force. You feel like you're advanced and you're capable of doing anything on earth on the action level. But when you start to manifest yourself and having this great force, a beautiful force of emerging in you to manifest, then you have like mosquitoes. Thoughts, you know, thoughts that are, you know, that are there, and that you are not, you know, because you're not happy, or you feel like attacked by the thoughts of others, because the air element is related to the world of thoughts. So all the birds, the wind, the four elements are very important in symbolic language. Fire is our spirit, vital energy. Air is the world of thoughts, and water is the world of emotion. And earth is the world of action. And the categories, these are categories of symbol that we need. So you see that then after you see a tsunami, so when you start to be troubled with your thoughts or something is not going right, then your emotions are emerging. And then you can't communicate anymore. And you can't communicate. You're good at the beginning, but you're not good at the end. See, there's a lot of people like that. They're good when they start something, but then they have a lack of motivation, or there's whatever that's going to happen, and they're not capable of taking something and create multiplication like the angel Omael that we were talking about. Another angel that, you know, that we can work, which is related to Mihael, related to fertility, marital peace and harmony. It's related to marriage also. So if we have, let's say we would like to find the right spouse, we can use that angel and visit the soul of the other person. We ask God, we ask the angel, is it the right person for me? Do I have a sufficient affinity? So we will have a beautiful, beautiful relationship for all our lives. It's amazing to understand that we can know that. You know, I've been teaching that for a long time, and I know hundreds and hundreds of people that have been confirming their spouse through their dream. No one was saying that they found it through their dreams. It's very, very something that it's amazing, amazing when we can use our spiritual powers, when we can develop our angelic consciousness. This is what happens to us. We can ask questions. We can use an angel. Let's say we want to know about this. You know, we have a difficulty in our couple, and we would like to know, what should I do to improve myself? Then tell me, what should I do to improve myself and my couple? And then you do the invocation for a minimum of 5 days. Minimum of 5 days. So this way you can really focus on the third. Then you will start to receive dreams. And the more we work intensively, we start to see signs right away, the dreams right away, first time, etc. And all the dreams are focused. And then we receive an answer. We answer in the memories. And this helps to create a focus to go in a region of the consciousness. So this is what is amazing, is we can focus and we can enter more precisely. Because, of course, we continue to pray to God, but when we pray to God through the angels, then we have multiple aspects where it is more precise, it is less abstract, and it brings us answers, profound answers. So when we work, it's important, when we work with the angels, that we do not interpret them literally. You will see sometimes a major distortion, you say, wow, you know. But we have to see them in terms of degrees. Let's say we see a distortion and it's prostitution. We've never done that, never thought about that. But prostitution is when you put matter first. And when you do something that is not right for matter, you sort of prostitute your thoughts. You know, you just distort them and you just fuse with something that is not right. So it is a sort of, or you're too kind to make sure it's going to work. This is a little bit, this is the beginning of that energy. So we need to see them in terms of consciousness and in terms of degrees to really understand sometimes, even dreams sometimes. We can have nightmares about subjects that are not really nice to see, but we have to say, I have like maybe 0.0005% of my consciousness. I have to de-dramatize. If you want to work with dreams and symbolic language, you need to de-dramatize nightmares. You need to de-dramatize evil. You need to know that it is there to educate. It's like a child sometimes. He's always making, you know, things that are not right. But we love him because we educate him. We understand it's normal that he's doing mistakes. You see? But it's normal for us also. We're a scientist. You know, there's no scientist that succeed at the first time, you know. And to make sure they got the budget for the next year, you know, they need to know, they need to say, you know, while we discover something, we discover that something doesn't work. So, wow. So let's say, you know, we have, you know, but it's like, it's the notion, but it is normal because we learn from that. And this is how science has evolved through time. We've learned from mistakes and we've learned from discoveries of one and the other person. And this has created the knowledge that we have in our university, right? On the background, on the physical level. And it's the same thing, of course, with the universal knowledge. So here, when we do the angel recitation or the mantra, it creates an opening in the unconscious. We enter very, very deep to visit the memories that we have accumulated over time. So we enter the subconscious, you know, memory preparing to go down into the unconscious or to emerge into consciousness. Then we enter the personal unconsciousness, the memories of entire experience since the very beginning of life in the womb. Then family unconsciousness, ethnic unconsciousness, collective unconsciousness, etc. And we go deep, deep, deep to understand that we are all the countries within ourselves. Sometimes we are born in India. Other time we're born in Africa and America and Europe. We can, you know, we need to integrate the qualities of all the countries. Because a country is like a person. It's an egregore. It's like a person plus and minus. And the same thing when you die. Some people, they ask me sometimes, what's happened when we go, when we die? The best way to explain that to someone that is in the threshold of death or is having this great question. Best way to say, remember one of your most vivid dreams. One that was so real that you woke up in the middle of the night and you didn't even know. You know, it took 10 seconds to know, is it this the dream or was it the bear that was chasing me? You know? So we're happy when it's not, you know, that we are in our bed and it's not the bear, that is the reality. But we do, we shift from one dimension to another. This is what we do. So dying is that. You enter in a dream and you don't come back. And this is what angelic consciousness is. The understanding, the capacity to travel to the multi-dimensions of the universe. And one day with the angel, we can do that precisely. We can go in certain aspects. We can have precise answers. We can have a path that becomes very, very, very concrete. And it's amazing what it can do. And it creates a new awareness also.